morning, children. Today, yesterday we discussed about how we are using the simple equations in our daily life situations. Today, we are going to learn those examples, some of the examples where we are using the simple equations. So, yesterday topic we will continue today also. Now, coming to the questions. So, yesterday, in case of numbers, how we are using the simple equations and how we are finding the required numbers, yesterday we have discussed. So today we will see in geometrical shapes how we are using the equations and age related problems. Okay, so in all those cases, how we are using the equations to simplify such type of questions, we will see now. Observe.
One exceeds the other by three, five numbers. So one exceeds one,
exceed the other member by 3. Okay, now think it out. X is equal to 95 plus 3 is 98 minus x. Bring x this side. X minus x is by bringing this side plus x, which is equal to 98. X plus x is equal to 2x. 2x is equal to 98. X will be equal to 98 by 2. 2 1 up. 2 4 by 8 and 2 9 by 18. So x is equal to 49. And that will be the other number. That is 95 minus x will be equal to 95 minus 49, which is equal to 34. So I have these two numbers, 49 plus 46. 9 plus 6 is 15, 9. So 9 is 30. 15 minus 6, 8 minus 4 is 2, so 46. So the two numbers are 95, 49 and 46. So for checking also, we can do even sum of those two numbers is equal to 95. So what are those two numbers? One number is 49 and another number is 46. It is equal to 95. Whatever condition we got, that is true. Okay, whatever answer we got, that is true. So this is by using only one variable. Okay, only one variable I am doing this. Only simple equation I have used here. So, when I told you in this problem, we can do with the two variables also. So, just try with the two variables. Let those two numbers be equal to x and y. Okay, and they only given that x plus y sum of those two numbers is equal to 95. This is the first condition. And if one exceeds the other by 3, so we will write x is equal to exceed the other member by 3. Other member by 3, that's all. So substitute x value in the equation 1. So substitute equation 2 in equation 1. What we will write, x is equal to y plus 3 plus y is equal to 95. Then y plus y is equal to 2y. And 95 is plus 3 by bringing this as minus 3. So this is now translated to simple equation. Okay. So y will be equal to, that is 2y is equal to 95 minus 3 is 92. Then y will be equal to 92 by 2. 2, 1, 2, 4, 4, 8, 2, 2, 6, 7. So one of the number is 46. Then find out the x value by substituting the equation 2 or 1. So from equation 2, x is equal to y plus 3. Y value we got 46 plus 3. 46 plus 3 is nothing but 46. So just observe.
Same answer will be get done.
So that because we are dealing with simple equations, I am using with only one variable. So even though two variables, the two variables are taken into the discussion. Okay. Now coming to the next problem. Integers is 24. Find the integer. Okay, this is the question. So now, so whenever consecutive integers are consecutive odd numbers, consecutive even numbers, they will use them again. Now, here the question is sum of the three consecutive integers. Consecutive integers is now, if I have 2, what is the consecutive number for 2? 3. Next number is 4, 5. So, 2, 3, 4, 5 are the consecutive integers. 4 consecutive integers. Now, they are asked only 3 consecutive integers. For suppose, my number is x0. Okay. Then, how I will get this one? 2 plus 1 is 7. And it is 2 plus 2. That means, x plus is true. And the three consecutive images. Now, first of all, I am taking any number 70, 80, 90, like 7 seconds. Now, even though let x is equal to 70, getting how will we get? X plus 1, 70 plus 1, and y 90, how do we get? For this 70 by adding 2 everywhere. That is x plus 2. Okay? So, consecutive integers are nothing but x plus 1, x plus 2, x plus 3, and so on. And if they are consecutive even numbers, so these are the consecutive numbers. That's all, consecutive numbers. Now, consecutive even numbers. First of all, what is the sequence for even numbers? 2, 4, 6, 8, and so on. Now, just observe how the pattern is generated. 2. Just observe all these values. All these values we get in multiples of 4. So, that is nothing but 2 ones are 2. 2 twos are 4. So, first of all, we are getting 2 into 1. To get the second term, 2 into 2. To get the third term, 2 into 3. Next, 2 into 4. Like that, till if I want the nth term, that is nothing but 2 into 8. 2 into 8 is nothing but 2 8 is my nth term. Take any value of anything. So, suppose I want first term value. So, first term, I want first term, what is the first term in this sequence? 2 into 1. I want first term. So, in we have to substitute 1. 2 into 1, 2. So, first term is 2. What is the second term? Second term, for second term, 2 into 2 we have to do. 2 is 4. 2, 3 is 6. 2, 4 is 8. Like that, okay? And the term is 2. A general pattern of this sequence is 2. Okay, expression from 2 n for even numbers. Now, if they are asking, find the three consecutive even integers whose sum is so and so number they do. In that case, how we have to find further, we have to take the integers. See, here those integers we don't know, we need to find. Consecutive integers, remember they are telling, I told you to take x plus 1, x plus 2, and so on. In case of even integers, consecutive even numbers, in that case, let first number is 2n and second number is 2n plus 2. Even numbers come. So 2. Next number will be 2n plus 4. Like just observe. I want first number 2 into n and that means 1. 2 into 1 is equal to 2. And my second term 2 into 2. If I am taking n is equal to 1. N is equal to 1. Then what will be the consecutive even integers to this? It is 4, this is 3. Even integers what will be left when n is equal to 1? 2, 1 are 2. My first integer is 2. And next one, 2, 1 are 2. 2, 2, 4. 2 plus 2 is 4. And 2, 1 are 2. 2 plus 4 is 6. Just answer. These 3 only, first 3 even consecutive integers. So, the general pattern, whenever they are asking to find out the so and so sum they will be asking to find the consecutive even integers. In that you must take the numbers as 2x, 2x plus 2, 2x plus 4, and so on. 2x plus 6, 2x plus 8, like that we must consider. If odd numbers include, so for odd number, what we will get? Just we will get one more number extra. This is 7. Even number plus 1 is equal to odd number. Even number plus 1 always equal to R. R number plus 1 is always equal to even. Now, even plus R. Even value we got 2n. So, R number will be 2n plus 1. So, how we have to take in case of R number that is 2n plus 1, 2n plus 3, R numbers 1, 3, 2n plus 5, and so on. Like this, we must consider the integers. So, observe the question. So, these are the different questions you must remember. So, whenever they are asking about to find the even in consecutive integers, in that case, you must take consecutive integers as x plus 1, x plus 2, x plus 3, like that you must take, and so on. And consecutive even numbers. will be equal to, we must characterize 2x, 2x plus 2, 2x plus 4, 2x plus 6, and so on. Even that. And that will give you R numbers. For this, we must consider the integers, we must consider the numbers like 2x plus 1, 2x plus 3, 2x plus 5, 2x plus 7, like this. Okay? So now our question is passing to the integers first one. So now therefore let F, so this is the solution. Let the three consecutive integers are, three consecutive integers are x, x plus 1, x plus 2, only three, because three only two. And given that sum of these three integers, sum of these three will be equal to 24. So sum of those three integers take x, x plus 1, x plus 2 is equal to 24. Now after finding the x value, find out the integers. So find out, simplify the any question mark. So 1, 2, 3, 3x plus 1 plus 3 is 3. Simplify the left side first. Now plus 3 double minus 3 minus 3. So 3x is equal to 24 minus 3. 3x is equal to 24 minus 3 is 21. X will be equal to 21 by 3. 3 ones are 3 7, which is equal to 7. So my first integer, x is equal to 7. X plus 1 is equal to 8. 7 plus 2 is 9. So 3 consecutive integers are 7 plus 8. 7, 8, 9. Find out the sum because the sum is equal to 24. Find out the sum. 7 plus 8 plus 9 is equal to 7 plus 8 is 15. 15 plus 9 is 24. So whatever numbers we got, those are correct. Okay, I hope you understood. So remember, whenever I are asking consecutive integers, let how many they are asking. For suppose here I have given four consecutive integers. In that case, let the four consecutive integers are x to x plus 1, x plus 2, x plus 3. Like that. And if I want four even consecutive numbers, in that case, 2x, 2x plus 2, 2x plus 4, 2x plus 6, my four consecutive even integers and four consecutive odd integers, 2x plus 1, 2x plus 3, 2x plus 5, 2x plus 7, like that we must do. Okay? So, very simple question. We are using simple equation to handle this question. Even only with one variable, we are simplifying that equation, that question. Okay? Now, coming to the next problem. Here, find the length and breadth of the rectangle. Given below. The rectangle given below. It is very nearly 72 meters. It is very nearly 72 meters. And my rectangle is 5x plus 4 and x minus 2. So, like this, the rectangle given. Find the length and breadth. What is its length? What is its breadth? We need to find out. Further, on the rectangle given below, if its perimeter is 72 meters, as already I told you, for a rectangle, either they will be perimeter or area. In that case, their dimensions we must add. We must find. And then we give the relation between length and breadth also. So here, any statement not given between length and breadth, but there are many given expressions. relations are. We need to find out what is the relationship between X and Y. Now they only give it, so it is very simple. So from the figure, it is very clear that from the figure, so anyone on the left hand side, L is equal to 5x plus 4 greater than or equal to meters, because perimeter given is meters, and length of the rectangle is equal to x minus 4 meters. Okay. Now given perimeter of the rectangle is equal to perimeter of the rectangle is equal to 72 meters. So what is the perimeter of the rectangle formula? Yesterday also we have something. 2 into L plus B is equal to 72 meters. So substitute L and B values. In this equation, substitute L and B values in equation 1, like a big equation 1. So, what do we get? 2 into L value is 5x plus 4 plus B value is x minus 4 is equal to 72. Okay, R units are in meters. Now, simplify whatever is there in the brackets are there. And this 2 is in multiplication with complex terms. So you can bring this 2 this way. And it is in multiplication. By bringing other side, it will become 3 units. So first of all, simplify these brackets 2 into 5x plus 4. So plus 4 will be in the bracket, x minus 4. Just we are removing the brackets. So plus 4 minus 4 will be cancelled. Is equal to 7. Now, 2 into 5x plus x, 6x. Only one more factor I am removing the brackets. Is equal to 72. 2, 6 are 12. 12x is equal to 72. Then, x will be equal to 72 by 12. 12 on the 12 is equal. Okay. Therefore, x is equal to 61. But, L is equal to 5x plus 4, which is equal to 5 into 6 plus 4. So 5, 6 are 30 plus 4. 30 plus 4 is equal to 34 meters. Length of the rectangle is 34 meters. And breadth is equal to x minus 4. That means 6 minus 4. 6 minus 4 is nothing but 2. So breadth of the rectangle is 2 meters. Now check your result. Perimeter is 72 meters given. 2 into L plus B. L plus B, how much will get? 34 plus 2. 34 plus 2 is 36. 36 2s are. 36 into 4. 72 will be. 6 are 12. 6 plus 2 is 12. 72 meters is correct. That means what we call the L and B values. Those are correct. Okay, checking also you must write. So for checking, whatever statement they are given, whatever equation they are given, there you must check. The average perimeter is equal to 72 meters. So take LHS. Very correct. Compulsory you are getting 72 only. So RHS is also 72. Means L and B values are correct. Okay. Now coming to the next example, depending on the same shape. Okay. So in this way, we are using the equation to simplify this topic. Length of the rectangle. Length of the rectangle. X is breadth by 4 meters. X is breadth by 4 meters. Here, relation given with the length and width. Statement given when you solve the equation. And now, If the perimeter of the rectangle is 84 meters, keep perimeter of meters. If the perimeter of the rectangle is 84 meters. Find its length and width. Find its length and width. Okay, we are giving the statement between length and width, so we need to find the expression between length and width. First of all, as I told you, first read the statement by statement. Length of a rectangle exceeds its breadth by 4 meters. So, length expressed in terms of breadth, this bar, which one we need to take as a variable? Second one, breadth and variable must be. So, length, breadth of a rectangle is equal to x. B is equal to x meters. And given, first statement, length of the rectangle is equal to, length of the rectangle is equal to, exceeds its breadth by 4, that is, B plus 4, breadth by 4, exceeds its breadth by 4 meters, that is, B plus 2, that is nothing but L is equal to B value equal to x, x plus 4 meters. So L and B values we have now. And also given that perimeter of the rectangle is equal to meters. So they only mentioned this, 84 meters. Now substitute all the values. What is that? 2 into L plus B is equal to, because perimeter, so perimeter of the rectangle formula is 2 into x is equal to 84 meters. That is the equation 1. And substitute L and B values in equation 1. And what we will get? 2 into L value is x plus 4 and B value is x is equal to 84. Now bring this 2 this set on my way. Instead of the brackets, x plus x is equal to 2x plus 4. 2x plus 4 is equal to 84 by 2. 2 1 the 2 4 the 8 to 2 some. So 2x plus 4 is equal to 42. Otherwise, if you want to multiply with the 2, you can. No problem. So now 2x is equal to 42 minus 4. 2x is equal to 42 minus 4 is 38. X is equal to 38 by 2. 2 1 is 98. So x is equal to 19 meters. That is, breadth of the rectangle is equal to 19 meters. Therefore, length will be equal to b plus 4. That is, x plus 4, which is equal to 19 plus 4. So, x is equal to 19 plus 4 is 23 meters. So, find out its perimeter. L plus B, 23 plus 19, 42. Yes? So 42 into 2, 82. So whatever values we got for L and B, those are correct. Now coming to the next problem. Age related problem. Frame of H will become four times the length of the circle H, four times the length of the circle H. So this is the question. After 15 years, cane of age will become 4 times the cut of our present age. Find our present age. So only one person. Okay. Let Hema's present age is equal to Hema's present age is equal to 8 years. And what is the given age after 15 years? Means first of all, what is the age of Hema after 15 years? So after 15 years, Hema's age will be equal to x plus 15 years. After, okay? Before means x minus 15, but after 15 years is x plus 15. Now, what is given? After 15 years, Hema's age will become, that is, Hema's age is equal to, present age is equal to, 4 times that answer, sorry, Hema's age will be equal to, 4 times the cut of the present age. 4 times of her present age. So this is the given relation. Observe, what are they given? I am taking present age is x after 15 years. First, suppose the person age is 10 years. After the 3 years, how much age will be? 7 plus 3, 10 years. So after 15 years, Hema's age will be equal to x plus 15. And given that Hema's age after 15 years will be equal to 4 times after present age. That is the first statement. So after 15 years, Hema's age will be equal to x plus 15 is equal to 4 times, that is 4 into present age of Hema is x, 4 into x plus 1. So x plus 15 is equal to 4 into x is 4x. Then x term is same. X plus 4x, that means the minus 4. It's like past time term, then right side. Plus 15 by 10 is the same, minus 15. So x minus 4x, that is plus 1 is minus subtraction. 4 minus 1 is 3. And 4 is added minus 10, so minus 3x is equal to minus 15. Then x will be equal to minus 15 by your minus 3 will have into. So by negative sign, you will become negative. By minus 3. Minus 9 will get cancelled. 3 will not be equal. X is equal to 5 years. What is our present age? 5 years. After 15 years, what will be our age? 5 plus 15, 20 years. So that is nothing but 4 times of x. 4 into 5, 20 years. So this equation will be satisfied and x is equal to. Okay, so once again I tell you, whenever age related problems are there, get the present age and the variables. And after the sum of the condition variables, after and before the other variables. So use that information and find out after means add, before means you must go for subtraction. So use that the statement, whatever statement you will need, from the equation, find out the age, present age. Compulsory they ask for present age. Okay. Now coming to the next problem. Money related problem. This is the case of money related problem. Like yesterday I had 10 rupees notes and 50 rupees notes. Example problem. Like that only we have to solve this question. The sum of 3000 rupees is to be the sum of ₹3,000 is to be given in the form of 63 prices. Given in the form of 63 prices. If the price money is either 10,000 rupees or 20,000 rupees. The price money is 100 rupees or 25 rupees. Find the number of rice for each day. Find the number of rice of each day. Okay, after this question. question. Yesterday we have total 250 rupees. We had in the amount of 10 rupees notes and 50 rupees notes. So instead of notes here, they are given. Then they are asking to find out how many number of 10 rupees notes are there, 50 rupees notes. Here in this case, floating money given 3000 rupees and it is given in the form of prices. Total number of prices is equal to 63, the only rule. And prize money either 100 rupees or 25 rupees. This 3000 rupees given in the form of 100 rupees and 25 rupees prices. Okay. Find the number of prizes of each type. So how many 100 rupees prizes are there? How many 25 rupees prizes are there? You must find.
Variable terms and constant terms we need to separate. Now, minus 75 x is equal to minus 3300, because 6300 is greater than 3000. Both are having unlike sense, so we need to go for subtraction. 6300 minus 3000 is 3300, and 6300 is having minus. So minus minus will get cancelled. X will be equal to 3300 by 75. Now, because we are going to get more than the 515 is 5 is 30, and 5 3 5 15, otherwise 5 3 15, 5 1 5 16, 5 3 15, 10, 5 2 10, now 3 10.
Okay, now coming to the next problem. Number 8
One party said more than the other, such that one party said more than the other. If the two parts are in the ratio 5:3, the two parts are two parts of the number. Two parts are in the ratio of, are in the ratio 5:3. Find the number and the two parts also. Find the number as well as and the two parts. So one of the number is divided into two parts. First, suppose my number is 3. I am dividing this number into 3 plus 2 plus 3. Okay, one part is 2, other part is 5 times of the first part. Very good. So there are given the relationship between these two parts. Ratio. So in case of ratio, also half the term is in the equation. This is a particular question. So now, the number is divided into two parts. Next, the number is equal to. So, number we didn't know. We don't know. Number is divided into two parts. Let the first part of the number. Let the first part of the number is equal to. First part of the number is equal to x. And other part of the number is 10 more than the other. Means other part will be equal to first part plus 10. This one given in the question number 10 more than the first part. Understood? So first part is x, second part will be x plus 10. And given that if the two parts are in the ratio 5:2, ratio of those two parts, ratio of the parts is equal to x, 5:3. Now, okay, 5:3 given, okay. But 5 parts is for which number and 3 parts is for which number we need to do it. Observe, x for suppose 5 I have taken, x plus 10 will be 5 plus 10, 15. This is the greater number and first one is the smaller number. So, here greater parts to smaller parts they are given the ratio. X plus 10 is to x we have to take, not x is to x plus 10. Remember, greater number, greater parts, smaller number, smaller part. That's it. That will be the that one only the important thing. So that is x plus 10 is to x is equal to 5:3. I am not taking x is to x plus 10 because greater part to greater number and smaller part to smaller number we have to take ratio. We need to take correct answer. They don't really get the correct answers. Otherwise, we will not get it. Now, these two ratios are in proportion. A is to B is equal to C is to D. So, when we are ready, those two are in proportion. If the product of extremes is equal to product of means, otherwise, instead of this, both of these, change the ratio into A by B form. That is, x plus 10 by x is equal to 5 by 3, that is 3 is nothing but 5 by 3. Now, also with the class multiplication, 3 into x plus 10 is equal to 5 into x, class multiplication. This denominator will be multiplied by the numerator in the left side, and here denominator will must multiply with the numerator of the next side, right? Now, so if you can remove the brackets first of all, 3 into x, 3x plus 3 10 to the 30 is equal to 5x. Now, take x terms on the right, first term comes right side. That is 3x plus minus by bringing this side, it will become minus 5x is equal to plus 30 by bringing this side, minus 30. Now, 5 minus 3 is 2, 5 is having minus 10, so minus 2x is equal to minus 30. Minus minus will get cancelled. X will be equal to 30 by 2. So, x is equal to 1 by 2 15. 15 means one part is 15, other part is equal to x plus 10, that is 15 plus 10, 20.
and they are asking to find out the number and the two parts also. So two parts, x is 15, x plus 10 is 25, and number is equal to number is x plus x plus 10. These are number. That is 15 plus 25, which is equal to 40. So total number is 40. That 40 is divided into two parts. One part is 15, other part is 25. The ratio 25:15 is the number. 5 is 5, 3 is 5, 2, 3. That's it. So very simply, here ratio combination we are using. Okay. Tomorrow we will continue the class with some other examples.